changed career paths many times. First, I wanted to be a teacher, like my mom. And then I wanted to be a singer, the next Taylor Swift. Finally, I wanted to be an actress, because what 10-year-old doesn't want to be on Disney Channel? Whatever I thought my future occupation would be, an engineer was not it. Engineering wasn't even on my radar. In my opinion, math and science weren't for girls, they were for nerdy boys. It sounds silly, but it's true. When I was a kid, I imagined engineers and scientists and mathematicians as really smart men in lab coats discussing complex theorems years beyond my understanding. I thought women in STEM were anomalies, and for a woman to be an engineer, she had to be some kind of prodigy. And then, one day, my older stepsister told me that she wanted to be an engineer. And I realized then that women in STEM weren't rarities. They could be anyone. A female in engineering doesn't have to be a prodigy, just like a male in engineering doesn't have to be a prodigy. And I decided then that I wanted to be an engineer too. After making the choice to follow this new career path, I started to realize it's a whole lot easier for guys. In most cases, from the time they're little, boys are taught how to use tools and put things together. They're the ones that are pushed towards cars, and we're the ones that are pushed towards Barbies. Toys that inspire passion to go into engineering, like robots and Legos, are typically marketed towards boys. And the ones marketed towards girls aren't trucks or spaceships, they're princess castles and pet shops. I think it's the little things that cause the gender gap in science and math careers. The rare little comment that girls aren't as smart as boys. A son being taught how to fix a car while a daughter is taught how to cook. It's nobody's fault. We unconsciously do these things because gender differences and inequalities are things that have been around for a long time, and now they're drilled into our heads. We solve the larger issues at hand, like women's suffrage and equal education, and now it's time for us to fix the little things so that we can grow even closer to achieving equality. The lack of women in STEM isn't all across the board, however. In fact, in areas such as medical science and social science, the ratio is actually very balanced. But in careers that are often considered more taxing, such as computer science and mathematics, women make up about a quarter of the workforce. I want that number to even out. There's a constant bias against girls from the beginning. Teasing, stereotyping, marginalization. Countless articles discuss how women feel out of place in classes relating to STEM, due to reasons such as other classmates mocking them, or the professor not paying as much attention to them, or lack of other female classmates in the class. And if gender equality isn't reason enough for wanting more women involved in STEM, take into account the scientific discoveries that have been made by women. Cardiovascular disease symptoms had always been based off of male symptoms, despite the fact that it manifests very differently in men and women. The average male is the model for investigating diseases and designing treatment because men were the ones doing the research. For years, women died from incorrect diagnoses because no one took into account that a person's sex could have such an effect on how a disease appeared. Now that more women are getting involved in medical research, however, they themselves are taking into account these differences and are consequently saving lives. Women have been advancing the fields farther ahead for centuries. Ada Lovelace created the plans for a machine that could perform complex mathematical calculations. She did this in the early 1800s. It was never built during her lifetime, but her plans were used a century later to build the world's first computers. One of the world's first electronic computers, called the ENIAC, was programmed by six female mathematicians. Now, Amy Sheng, an engineer, is developing a smartphone attachment called CellScope, which allows mothers to detect ear infections in their children. Hadia Nicole Green, a medical physicist, is designing a cancer treatment that uses lasers to destroy cancer cells exclusively. Despite these achievements, women are still isolated in STEM fields. I could also get into other problems, such as the gender pay gap, but the fact is that we have made so much progress, and yet we are still miles away from the finish line. It's because of the internalized beliefs we don't notice, present inside of both men and women. Project Implicit conducted an investigation on 500,000 people and found that 70% of them automatically associated men with science and women with the arts. My goal is to get the word out there that any little girl or boy can be anything they want to be, including an engineer. They don't have to be a prodigy to be a scientist or mathematician. As long as they work hard, they can be anything they would like to be. Parents, teachers, and friends shouldn't hold them back. They should encourage them. I want that internalized bias to be gone, because that's what stopped me from wanting to be an engineer when I was little. And I don't want it to stop anyone else from wanting to be an engineer ever again. Thank you.